Hi, I'm Sandy Graffius, your county controller. Don't you like that? Hi. And I want to report that I have on my Daisy May outfit. Could you please go down so that they could see my fingers? See my, what do you call these?
Your fringe.
My fringe, yes. Thank you. That was nice of you. Now, today we have with us the Children's Home of Reading, or if you like acronyms, it's CHORE. Isn't it?
That's right.
Chore. Yeah. That means that you have something to do, though. Chore.
I know.
Obviously, you guys have stuff to do, don't you?
Always. All right. But the kids don't always have to do everything.
Now, I want to tell you that Jill is dressed tonight. The last time we were on, my buddy here, Vince, uprooted a tree in his front yard because it was raining so hard. And within 10 minutes of the show, she had to be on. She ran down the drugstore, bought makeup. She went out in her car and bought this huge wraparound thing that covered her whole body and the rest of the studio. And she had on pants that would knock your eye out because of the design. So
yes, they were paisley. So now today I have the paisley top and the solid brown, and I'm coordinated.
Well, I walked in, and I mean, she really cleans up nicely when she knows she's going to go on the show. And Vince has no trees falling down.
No. So, everything's
so
good
we're
tonight.
Here. We're all here.
Yeah. We're not only here. We are here with so much fun stuff to talk about. We're going to start with Celebrity Chef. Now, once a year, you folks have a function at the Doubletree,
Yes. And
you get a whole bunch of, I was going to say, poor souls together, because I'm one of them. But you encourage / bully, bribe, and cajole people to be a celebrity chef. And then they have to bring food for 400 people, and then you sell tickets. And then people come in, they just go all around the Doubletree, and they graze. And there's all kinds of food to eat. Now, you folks use that as a fundraiser.
Yes.
The tickets are $40 ahead of time, $50 at the door.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be on, now I know I'm going to say the wrong person's
Martin
name.
Martin Luther King.
Thank
Day.
You very much. This is why she's on the show with me. So that.
Well, look, right up on the screen, they have it for us so that we can see.
Look,
the quest for this, the golden spatula.
Yeah, now I want to tell you, I don't bother going for any golden spatulas. I just go for stuff that I have enough food. And last year, I made turkey sliders. Oh, my gosh, I will never do that again. I had picked turkey for 400 sandwiches for 4 days. I'm picking turkey off the bones, and I thought, I will never do this again. So this year, I'm doing pigs in a blanket, and I want to tell you, they come already made up of PJs. and so on Sunday.
She's just coming to feed and have fun with a whole bunch of people. So I think we have some photos. I brought a few so that everybody can see how much fun it is. So
okay,
our first one is to lining up.
Okay, you go ahead and I take it. You kid.
Okay, so this is one of the tasting chefs who has prepared, and you see small samples. It's not there to be, for you to have a huge amount of food. It's just for you to nibble, and then you get 3 tickets to choose.
Well, how many chefs do you have?
We have 36 right now.
And so if you eat too much at one table, you don't get
right.
A gondola table.
And here is our corn and black bean salsa, which is to die for. And then, you know, this is Boomy, who is one of the people who is on the committee. This is her chicken salad. I asked her for the recipe. She said, I don't know. I make it different every time. But let me tell you, every time she makes it, it is so good.
Well,
and she did it with lettuce wraps this year, which was really fun.
Yeah, she takes lettuce leaves and puts the chicken in there.
Yep.
And I'll tell you what, you can only take one at a time, but if you keep passing by her table and her husband doesn't catch you.
You get more than one, right?
You get more than one.
You can get it behind your back.
And here is the LaSorsa clan, who did a wonderful blueberry cake last year. That was so good. So we have desserts. And this year, we're very excited. We have not only the golden spatula, we have the golden ladle for people who make soups.
Yeah,
or chowders
we get
or chilies,
a lot of soups. We get
right?
A lot
because
of soup.
We had a whole lot, and everybody was wondering what was going on. And then for those who love the decadence of a dessert, we have the golden whisk.
And we should say that it's a tailgating theme, and you can see the eagles there.
And Vince, what do we have to say about the eagles after yesterday?
Yeah, big win.
Big win. So here's kind of an overview of you know, it is just starting here with people being left in. You can see everybody taking a sample. And then this is one of my favorite tables. And Sandy, does that look familiar to you?
Oh, that's my stupid turkey sliders.
That is the Graffius table, all lined up and ready to go with her chafing dishes and all her samples. She was just awesome.
We had so doggone much food.
And this was fun. This was a tower popcorn. So everybody gets into something a little bit different. It's a theme of tailgating. So you can just have fun. It's really a wonderful event.
And it's jammed. Yeah. Everybody sees people that they
and know. There you can see it's jammed.
And then they have music, which is just playing all the time. And so people come up to your table and you stick your ear out so they can talk right to you.
This year it's Latitude 24 who will be playing, and they are doing great hits as well. But this is a fun time. If you're looking for a great night out, things have calmed down after the holidays a little bit. We're all getting back into work, but in 2 weeks we'll be looking for something to do.
It's Martin Luther King Day.
Yeah,
6 to 8, right?
6 to 8 p.m. Yes, and the doors will not open until 6 o'clock for all the people to come in. But we actually have bouncers this year so that people can't come in early along with all the chefs. So the chefs will be prepared, the doors will open at 6, and you will have until about quarter till 8 to decide, you know, who is going to win. You have your 3 tickets, you get 2 complimentary beverages, adult beverages if you'd like, and you know, taste to your heart content.
I have to tell you that we as chefs make for 400.
Yeah.
So if everybody doesn't get pushy, there's
for everybody. That's correct. Because not everybody's going to eat a bite of everybody's stuff. You know, we ask you to do for 400 people because, and last year we had almost 600.
Yeah, we had over 500 people last
year.
Get out.
Yeah. No. Well, 2 years ago we made fried pickles.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my word.
Yeah.
I had gotten all kinds of dipping sauces, which ended up being salad dressings, and I had like 8 of them going across so that they could dip their pickles. They didn't eat it. They didn't eat the dips. I had all those bottles of salad dressing left over. I'm like, and I don't eat salads. I'm like, oh my gosh, I can't believe it.
Well, and I should say, this cooking for 400, we are not asking you to cook a full portion for 400. We're asking you to cook
samples.
Just samples, so 1 or 2 bites. So maybe 1 ounce or 2 per person. So really it's not a huge, huge, huge amount. Except for when you're Santa Graffius, who has
the first year
2
I made
turkeys,
macaroni and
4
cheese.
Porks.
Yeah, I did. I had pulled pork also.
You had a ton of mac and cheese left too.
Oh
right?
My gosh, I made 5 9x12 of mac and cheese. I thought everybody was gonna come like you'd eat for mac and cheese.
No, we
and
just
ham.
Do 1 or 2 bites. 1 or 2 bites.
I had 2.5 things left over. I took it into work. I emailed my staff, bring in leftover containers. I'm bringing in mac and cheese. So I took it in there. It was homemade. It was delicious. I was so nervous. That was my first year. I would get up at 2 o'clock in the morning and make a batch of macaroni and cheese and freeze it. What I didn't think about was the fact that to cook 2 at a time in your oven, it didn't get finished that fast.
Right.
Yeah.
And
right.
At 6:02, I was bringing in my food. And because I was so late, I was at the back of the room. Carrying my Mac. Yeah. Boy, I'll tell you what, I show up not 3:30. I get a table up front.
Right. You get a table up front. Well, we'll make sure that you get a table. Jen has it already laid out. She's got, we still have room for some chefs if anybody is interested. They can certainly call 610-478-8266. And extension 429, I had to think about that, 429, and ask for Jen Rummel. She will be happy to get you a packet out of for the celebrity chef. And, you know, if you're interested in doing that, this is a fabulous, fabulous fun event. And we have to say thank you to Marge Bly, who is
she
from
runs
Tower
it every
Pop.
Year.
Oh, yeah. It would be nothing without her and her committee that she has, and Tower Health, who, you know, and Reading Hospital, who really work well with us.
Oh, we get a lot of the doctors.
I know.
We
and
get
they are doctors. Serious.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
they want to win the competition, right?
Yeah, now I could give a rip about winning the Golden Ladle. I just want to go there and see all my friends.
Yes. And that's what it really is all about, is just camaraderie and having a really good
time. I take 2 people with me, my 1 staff person and the girl from elections, And then I say to them, do you mind watching the table while
and then you gallivant around.
Yeah, then I walk around hugging people and talking to everybody and trying everything, eating everything. Then I go back, checking the table, see how my staff is doing. And then I go,
oh, my gosh.
And I run around.
I mean, it's a great event. I mean, we're very proud of it. It's a fun event. There's no real program.
You make about
25,000.
Wow.
My goal is this year's the fifth year. It's 5 years this year. And, you know, my goal was to get to 50 chefs. We're not quite there. We're almost to 40.
But do you know why?
It's just so much fun.
As a chef, if you don't mind me telling you this, which I tell you anyway, I don't know if we could get any more chefs in the Doubletree ballroom.
Oh, they have room. It's not in the ballroom. They'd be out in the foyer. We'd move you out to the foyer. We'd have a whole selection there. Maybe we do appetizers there for next year. And what would we give? A golden skewer or something? I don't know. Tongs?
A fork.
A fork, a golden fork, something.
That's funny.
But it's really to benefit all of the children's home programs, which is really what it's all about. And, you know, we have 15 programs this helps to support.
I want to get to that because the last time we were together and we talked about Celebrity Chef, I have so much fun doing that I forget what it is supporting. So let's back up.
Sure.
And we're going to do a quick summary of what we talked about the last time when Mr. Vince was home picking up his tree. And you were here.
And lots of other people.
And you were here in your finery. And we're just going to move right along. I know that you have youngsters that live at the facility. I know that you have youngsters that come in after school for programs. Is that correct?
Yes.
All right. On your actual campus itself, how many youngsters can you house?
We have 72 beds in our residential program.
And is that boys as well as girls?
Boys and girls.
Okay.
Teenagers, 12 to 18.
All right. And how do they get placed there? Through the courts?
They can come through the courts. They could come through children and youth. They could come families, other referral sources.
Now, you also have after school. Is that aid with the homework? Is that counseling? Is that sociability? How do you structure your after-school programs?
We have an after-school program that's called an evening reporting center. And those are kids that really come through the courts and probation. And they are kids that we pick up at the schools that they attend during the day.
Oh, you even transport them?
Yep, and then transport them home at 9 o'clock at night. But they're with us for that afternoon period of time to do homework, to get engaged in different groups, different community outings.
Now, how many do you have that you're doing that for?
There could be 15 at a max.
I just happened to get, this is because we are raising money beside Celebrity Chef. I was unaware that you had a program for mamas. I want you to talk about that.
The Mrs. Program. Yeah. So our Mrs. Program is for women who are struggling, may have been dependent on drugs or alcohol.
Okay.
May have lost their children or may be in the process of getting their children back. We are working with them to give them the social work aspect, help them find their way to being the best parent that they possibly can.
How do you find them to begin with?
They come to us from a variety of places. They're referred to us.
Okay.
One of the things that we work with, they're anybody from 18 on up.
Okay, go ahead.
18 on up. So they may have custody of their children. They may be working on getting their custody back, but we're trying to make sure that they are getting the best possible treatment that they possibly can, adhering to those goals that they're setting for themselves.
Are they coming to you for the whole day? Are they coming to you an hour a month? Are they coming? What's the program?
I mean, it varies.
It varies. It's all based on each individual and what they need. So somebody may be working toward, their goal may be to get a job.
Okay.
To be financially stable so that they can keep their child.
Okay.
And maybe get off of welfare. Maybe they may be trying to get a car. But the biggest thing is that they are trying to be the best parent that they possibly can, because at some point they lost their way.
And tell me again how you find them.
So they come to us from a variety of places. So
a lot of times they'll come directly from an emergency room,
right.
a doctor's visit. where they get tested and
something
shows up.
And then they're referred to you for your program. Mm-hmm.
And we work closely with children and youth.
Okay.
Right, because our goal is always to make sure, and just like the state's goal, is to make sure that the children stay with their families. You know, but we want to make sure that the child is safe.
Yeah.
So we're trying to make sure that that mother is getting the help that she needs. So we're making sure that she's going to her appointments, that she's getting the care that she needs to help to rehabilitate her.
Do you give her financial aid or spiritual, emotional aid?
We help them with some things for the household. So maybe if they need diapers or they may need, they may not have a bed for a child. You know, that may be one of the things that they're missing in their household.
Is this part of your budget, or do you have people coming and donating things to you that you can give to them?
It's part of our budget. We don't like to give out used things because, for obvious reasons, with cleanliness and everything else and the sanitary, you know, we don't want to be transferring germs along. As much as we would love to be able to use things, our program cannot.
Well,
so we're trying to make sure that they're getting clean diapers. They're getting a they may have clothing, so baby clothing. You know, they may need blankets.
We run into, I say we, even though I don't work there. People will tend to take black trash bags of clothing to different places, and they get rid of their junk that way.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And it's not especially clean, dry cleaned, and it's not especially washed and ironed. And they just clean out their stuff and put it in a bag and dump it off at Safe Berks or someplace like that. And it's a real problem.
Mm-hmm. Well, we do have a place for people who want to get rid of their gently used clothes. We do have, we're partnering with an organization right now called Community Aid. And we do have one of those dumpsters that you normally would see where people might put their clothing in or used shoes, gently used. And we have that down at our day academy so that people can put things in there. And then what happens is that store cleans them, processes them.
Oh, and gets them ready.
And gets them ready for other people to buy, like a consignment shop.
Is that on South 6th?
It's off of Spring Street.
Spring Street and Nichols.
Well, then that's another one.
Yeah. Spring and
because
Nichols,
I'm going to be having a community store on that's South 6th Street, and it's part of a food, providing food as well as providing clothing to go get jobs and stuff like that.
No, this is different from that. This is, we will get, we get a portion of the proceeds when they sell it, so.
Are they part of your organization, or did they just find you?
No, we actually found them. We actually found them because we have so many people who want to do good things, and we can't take it for obvious reasons because of what our standards are and what we have to adhere to as an organization. So
when your youngsters come in, and I use that word youngsters even though they're teenagers, when they come in, are they accepted for a specific length of time? Do you know how long they're going to be staying?
I mean, most of the kids stay with us 6, 8, 10 months.
Okay.
And it all depends. It depends on the disposition, where the kid will go after they leave us, how they progress through treatment. Some stay much longer and some not as long. It really is very individualized.
Right, and it depends on the program. I mean, if it's residential, that's one thing. But we also have the Chore Day Academy, where kids from all different school districts around Berks County and outside of Berks County who come in, and the kids are, they have their own individualized educational plan, an IEP, to help them. They may be behind in something. They may be having some...
So you're doing tutoring?
School.
It's school. We actually have two schools.
Two licensed schools.
We have two licensed schools. We have one for our residential children on our campus.
Okay.
Because some of our kids can't work in a regular school under the conditions of what a regular school offers. And then we have the Chore Day Academy, which is a program for the public children who can't handle being in a regular school day program.
So then you have teachers coming in, and you have the school atmosphere right there.
Yep. They also can get, some children need medication during the day because they might have some... emotional issues that are going on that they have to, they may not be able to get along in a regular classroom. They may have some ADHD or they may have some ADD, but our kids are able to, thanks to the United Way and some of the programming and the Berks Bar Association. They do have a special software that they help to fund every year for us.
We have 2 minutes.
I want an hour.
Sir, I'm sorry. We have 2 minutes. So I need to know if you want volunteers, and if so, who they contact.
They can contact Tina Kruger.
Okay.
And Tina Kruger's number is 610-478-8266, and her extension is 569. And we always need volunteers always. For a variety of different things, whether it be somebody to be an advocate for our children at a special event or a community event
talk
that's
faster.
Going on. Talk, okay. Or we can always use chefs on January 21st, and you can meet Santa Graffius, and she'll sign an autograph. At the Doubletree for
a celebrity chef. I'll shove a hot dog, a pig in a blanket in your mouth. She's also around. I can't. It's always a delight having you folks on, and thank you for coming back. I wasn't too tough on you.
No, thank you.
No, but Sandy, if I can do anything, I'd just like to say thank you. And I know on Vince, we'd like to say thank you to the community, and especially to our chefs who help out, and our volunteers and community members, because on behalf of Children's Home, there's 1,100 kids every year that are being served.
Yeah.
And their families. So if you think somebody has four people in a family, that's over 5,000 people that we hit every year. So we hope, we love their support. We love people's support financially, time-wise, whatever.
Martin Luther King Day.
Yep.
6 to 8 at the Doubletree. $40 ahead if you want to get something from the chef. $50 at the door, right?
Right. Yes. And they can get those tickets online at our website. They just have to go to the event page and click
on it. I've got to tell you, don't eat before you come, because...
A lot of food, yeah.
It is a lot of food, and the desserts are wonderful, and I will have plenty of
hot dogs.
I'll have plenty of dipping sauces left over from my pickles that if they want to dip it in Caesar dressing, I've got
it. You've got it.
Thank you so much for being with me.
Thank you.
How's that? And you are lovely.
You are
lovely, darling.
I love with you being on here with you and talking about the kids. It's just
thank you. I don't know what's on next week. I know you're supposed to say that, but I have no idea. So tune in at 6:30. Whatever it is, it'll be my surprise for you. It won't be me. Goodbye.